Hello YouTube, this is Jeff Fortnite Fail JJ from Channel JJ coming back to you for another video. And yeah, I actually turned this video that's playing, it goes off when the concert starts. So yeah, don't be discouraged, continue, watch the whole thing. Bro, I don't even know why there's an Ariana Grande concert at all. I mean on Fortnite, bro. Seriously? Man, my word. Exactly what I'm thinking. Now, I'm going to turn this off when the concert actually starts, but yeah, this is some bullcrap right here. I don't know why this is an Ariana Grande concert. The only reason why I'm doing this. I'm gonna turn this off when the concert comes on. I just risked the hope. I see you.
Whack. Whack, okay.
How old is he?
About 62? But he was like, yo, that is gonna become dangerous what he's doing.
And I was like, why? Because he's running around killing SMD. They let him wild out. But him wilding out, a lot of people gonna end up getting hurt because of that trolling shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, everybody not playing, everybody not listening to that SMD. You know what I'm saying? And it got real crazy. Everybody's trying to one up me. I was on that. What way?
we in the street, we active, and they don't have anything to do with any of that directly. But now they can make their own history amongst their own neighborhoods and things of that nature get amplified. Because nobody wanna get left in the dust when it comes to Who is this? We know he ain't bounced that night. Did they reach out to him, or did he reach out to them? Because that will tell you if the feds are involved, if the government is involved, if the propaganda machine is involved to destroy hip-hop. Because again, there is no explanation for his meteoric rise, but he can't stick. He can't nothing about that. Able to overtake about people being inserted into certain spaces.
I'm gonna read that a little bit, because I know marketing and promotion, right?
Mm-hmm.
The kid, I made a video, the kid is a marketing. His marketing is something that I never saw before. The only person that I've seen market in this way is 50 Cent. So when you sit here and this kid come out with rainbow hair, we automatically think, all right, he part of the Memphis group, right?
Mm-hmm.
So, but then you find out he's not, and then he's around a bunch of Bloods, and I'm like, come on, how the Bloods letting a fun boy around them? But then I'm looking, and I look in the back, and I'm like, yo, that's, hold on, what's going on? So I started making phone calls. What's happening? What's happening? And that, yo, I'm going to be real with you. That momentum we seen in this city, we ain't never seen nothing like that before. It wasn't about spitting. It was about the movement. You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah, who did that?
You got to remember who
he
signed.
Did he say, I'm going to get around these dudes, and I'm going to blow up? Or did they say he paid them to be in the bin? Like what would make them get behind him?
They saw bag, man, because at the end of the day,
how can you see it if it's not there? Like I'm saying,
the potential.
Did they push him?
Yeah, I think they did push him. I think they got behind him and pushed him. The potential is there. You gotta remember, at the same time, these are dudes that are was around Jim Jones forever, and they, you know, with all due respect, never got, they just do. Mm-hmm. So now they got something outside of him that's about to go? Oh, nah, we gotta go crazy with this. You understand what I'm saying?
So they put the bag behind him.
I don't think it was a bag.
I'm trying to figure out.
I don't think it was a bag per se, but the attention, yo, it was easy to get it though. It was, listen, if we seen somebody, I remember it was a dude in a damn wedding dress with a shotgun that went viral. We never heard no music.
Right.
But everybody was looking at it. But when you see a kid with rainbow hair, mad pounds of weed, and we know straight up and down, us from the town know who's behind him, we like, yo, hold up. This about the man first.
Right.
They was freestyling on the beat. And it was loud music. It was Onyx mixed with all types of stuff. It had nothing to do with him spitting. It was just the movement. Hip hop is about movement. And we buy into movement just like we bought into Dipset movement. And it just so happened the music was good. Just like we bought into G Unit movement. Listen, dudes are listening to the same lunatic. You understand what I'm saying? It's about the movement, the buzz, and he has this rock star energy that's different. And then you got dudes that's like this. You better not touch me. You better not look at me. You better not say nothing. Then you say, yo, I'm the king of New York.
Mm-hmm.
And then Jim Jones go and say, well, I guess he is the king of New York. You know what I'm saying? So somebody who we thought should be in opposition to that, who put out music, who could claim King if he wanted to. Everybody kept giving it to him. He's the hottest thing, he's the hottest thing. So at the end of it all, he earned it. And then he just kept dropping a record. The records kept coming, then the marketing. Then he had Bloods in the video, and Crips in the video. It's like, yo, what's going on in New York City? Like, New York City is on fire right now.
Right, but again, so he's not a civilian.
No, I'm not saying, I'm never going to agree to that.
He's not a civilian. Again, that's where it came from. Between millions and that. Music, you in this element.
Yes.
So everything you're doing, he's witnessing. For a part of, and if it comes to a point where he's initiating it, instigating it, he's not no civilian. He knows what comes with it. Because people are going down in that mix. Prior to anything, you know what those types of things, you know, like a lot of
Listen, let me explain to people what a civilian is, because I see people and some of them in the damn chat saying he is a civilian. And y'all buy into dumb shit because you regurgitate, you don't research. First and foremost, right? The minute you commit a crime, you're not a civilian no more. You are a damn criminal. So that's that. A civilian don't commit crimes. A civilian is a hardworking, upstanding man and woman. And they go to work, they're not upset that he wanted to, and this is on record, so I'm not saying nothing that nobody don't know. The minute he bust that move with Kuda B and gave him that money, you're no longer a civilian, because now you're paying for people to be harmed. That's not what civilians do. That's what criminals do. You understand what I'm saying? So at the end of it all, stop saying he's a civilian. How is he a civilian? So what? So gang members are civilians now?
Right, no fight! Again, because of what knowledge comes to me, and from what I know, that going on out there on the other coast.
Heck, I'm not gonna cut this out. Or no, I'm just not gonna put his name in the video, and I'm not gonna mention all, I'm just not gonna mention this. Cause dog would be like, yeah, I don't give you permission to use my audio, or I'm just not gonna mention you, bro. Nobody's coming here for you. They can't get Rory out of Ghana. Besides, that's fair use. Besides, this is fair use anyway.
Yeah, why y'all, I don't even know why y'all infatuated with that dude.
He's not a gang member.
Yeah,
he's not talking about it. We're talking about somebody who are in that mix. He ain't got nothing to do with none of that.
Yeah.
At all.
Yeah, y'all keep bringing it up. And that's from Mr. Good Music. I agree, you know what I'm saying? But again, listen, the illest thing about it is that once you sign up and you take an oath, you're taking an oath to criminal behavior, because it ain't like they was out there feeding the kids and shit, he was giving out money and all types of shit, you know what I'm saying? He was trying, but then he got caught up in the criminal enterprise of it, and that's what he told. You understand what I'm saying? That's what he told.
Let's not allow the narrative to shift.
Mm-hmm.
Because that's what we're doing here. I want to get and stay in the pocket of the conversation.
Yes.
Where this elder is out of line for speaking the way he did it, and not allowing this to be a teacher moment. Because you're trying to, again.
3 minutes? 25 seconds.
To a street element where, again, those two dudes are rappers. You understand what I'm saying? If he's saying that 6ix9ine is a civilian, and he walked on 21 and said, dude, just a rapper, and we know, for whatever we know, that dude, is he claiming anything?
Who's that? 21?
21.
No, not that I know.
Right? So, what are you doing? as the elder and the only one who is really affiliated, who is really in that light, who can really stake claim to it. What are you doing as the elder to take this narrative back to the street?
I don't know, and he lied in, and I felt like he allowed 6ix9ine to go on a gas.
Yeah, what?
I didn't like that.
Again, what we spoke on before, prior, did you? Gassing these whole ass dudes up to be straight, to talk shit, to say that you were being influenced by the machine, and not influencing the people that are be better. I saw your grandpa. You telling me he coached you and coached into me?
Yeah. We like the same age.
Come on. Where we going now?
Minute.
And why in public?
How long is the concert gonna be? What, about 20 segments? This is. Doggone it.
Generations of you that side in 21 is going to see. That's what we'll be talking about with these old kids. We'll be talking about with them.
Because that's what's happening. That's exactly what's happening.
You understand? You can't walk with anybody. So you just again, who are you working for? Who are you working for? Who are you working with? That's my question.
My thing is, what I'm not understanding is that, why is he going so hard for this dude? Like, why are you so involved? Like, you said you brought him on the clubhouse. Why? Why is 6ix9ine's word? Why are you making his word worth something? Good, bad, and indifferent? Like, I feel like with 6ix9ine, right?
But from what I'm hearing, it was a prior call.
Yeah. 6ix9ine
and
21.
21,
yeah, exactly. Yep.
You understand?
Yep.
So now you telling him he should have parked him where he's seen. Come on, yo. Look, them and who the kid? I just seen it. Dark Low. Son just got 7 joints. For intimidating a witness.
Yes.
Intimidating. You mean to tell me that this dude 21, everything that he built, all the momentum that he got, he's supposed to risk it all to park a rat?
Only thing I will say though, don't talk shit about somebody and you see him, you don't do nothing. That's the only thing. Don't talk shit. But let me get to the super chat really quick. Mr. Goody Music said, Wack is just in this for entertainment. He's promoting the boxing match between 6ix9ine and Blueface. I mean, Blueface is gonna beat the hell out of him, though. Like, but see, this is where we at. It's like everything is for a bad.
This promotion is dangerous, yo.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
We already seen the promotion and what how we lost Big and Pop.
Yeah.
This is the same type of promotion.
Yeah, let me get on this super chat. Tito Smile says 6ix9ine is disposing these so-called gangster snitches. Are walking around living their best life in every hood in America. The streets is faking in him. See, let me, Tell me. Y'all got it fucked up. Let me explain something to y'all, because ain't nothing fake about the streets.
There's
nothing fake about the streets. Dudes is outside getting bodied every day.
Bloody net. Connected without internet. Doggone it.
Bro, seriously, what is the problem?
Tekashi 6ix9ine finally sets the record straight. Or Jim Jones. Which leads to Jim Jones having a phone conversation with Mel Matrix, non-trade gangster Mel Murder, where he calls out Whack and calls Whack a clown for sitting down and having a conversation with the dude who got all the non-trade gangsters locked up.
Yes, this is going to be a put on pause. Time to listen to the content. I mean, it's looking all right, it's looking cool. I mean, but Ariana Grande ain't relevant. Well, this is probably something to make her relevant. I wonder if she's in a 360 deal. Is this going to come out her budget when her next song or album drops? This girl gonna be popular and broke. Now this looks like a ripoff of that the Surf's Up thing, for real. Or some game I've seen that did something similar where you was sliding around, bro. For real. And it's supposed to be an Ariana Grande. Why this, what's this, rapping or Brock or something? What's going on? And again, I wasn't really listening. Was that rapping? I don't know. But Ariana Grande don't rap. There we go. Now, I don't know who this is. This is Ariana Grande? It could be. But if this is more promotional music into the actual thing. See if we're real connect here. What's this? Buttons put you backwards. Oh, you're just not allowed to go to a certain point. You know, it is cool that they're making this a bit more interactive. I will acknowledge that. No, quiet, I'm making a commentary. You know, I've always did need to work on my aim. You know, with this thing moving and move forward, if I didn't press revive.
Down from the sky, an angel cries, she cries.
Ariana Grande, here we come. You know this? Are you saying it's gonna be released on DVD?
Something got on her, and now we're rushing in the shower. Prepare for the flowers.
Is this it? Thank you.
Okay, yeah. Well, when the first song started, and it was pretty much that Disney song, just reworked a bit, I was saying to myself, I was just about to say, this girl really, you know what, this girl kind of really does need a promotion, because she has no ideas. She can't push herself out the mud. Wasn't she stealing Soulja Boy's stuff and mixing it with another artist's stuff and made her little version of it? Yeah, so she kind of needs to push. And I mean, that Teapot Pots thing, what was that, a song from the Beauty and the Beast, man, that she just reworked? I think it's cool that they made it interactive. Am I about to listen to Ariana Grande after this? No. This girl's been putting out nothing pretty much, you know? She put out here was still pretty much nothing. She's making a bunch of pop songs. I just don't look at pop that finely. I mean, I guess this is it. I'm just gonna get my bar and I guess I'm gonna log out, see if we can play some games. God, this is so slow. But it's slower, but it's still faster than if I was on the field trying to kill people to get my XP. I might not finish it. Oh man, what should I tell this? I should cut this off from the concert. What should I call it? Me getting XP at Ariana Grande after Ariana Grande's tower. Me grinding at Ariana Grande's concert. Grinding for XP. but that's a clickbait title. Get a clickbait thumbnail. People want me clicking. Got it. Looks like it. Well, hey, all good things have to come to an end. And I was kind of getting a bit sick of this anyway. Wait, I didn't have to keep on continuously pressing, eh? I was wasting my time. Oh, come on. That is some bullcrap. Guess that's it. should have live streamed that.